Hey there, and welcome to another episode of Mr. P Explores. Today we're going to check out the river fords of the Cleveland Metroparks. Way back in the day, they had built the Valley Parkway through the Rocky River Valley, which someday went on to go form the Cleveland Metroparks. What they did was they built river fords over the rivers back then, because bridges were too expensive, and these fords went right down over the river. Later on, it became a real pain to keep them up because of the flooding and high waters, so they built bridges, but they left the road behind. So we're going to check out what these fords look like, and you'll be able to see an old example of 1930s road technology right here in Cleveland, right where nobody really knows they're even at. Some people probably might, but if not, you can come down here and check them out yourself. They're really kind of cool. So let's take a look at what's down here, and we'll see what there is to see. And as you can see, part of the old roadbed is still here from when they closed this back in the 1950s or 60s. I forget exactly when that was. But if you follow the path down here, this was actually where the road used to go. Valley Parkway used to be right where we're walking. And we're going to go out onto the ford. And to your left, you'll notice there's a bridge. That's modern day Valley Parkway. Right over there. Okay. And the ford continues on down towards the river. And as you can see, it's not in the best of shape. At some point there's mud and dirt and leaves, and it's pretty much buried. But you can see that this was the right-hand lane, and in the middle they had curbstones. And cars would have driven right over this and up the other side, reconnecting with Valley Parkway. These days, it's just a really cool place to come hang out, throw stones in the water, hike around. You never know what you're going to find washed up here after a flood. But we have a perfect example of what it's like when things dry out in Northeast Ohio. It gets really hot here sometimes, and we're lucky enough this fall that it hasn't rained in weeks. So this is usually all underwater. It's very hard to get to. This is a perfect time of the year to come out here and check it out. So we're in luck. As you can see, most of this has fallen into the river. The water has actually eroded underneath these fords and has brought it even further down. There's not any way you can get a car over this now. So as you can see, this river ford has been in better days. It just has totally collapsed into the river here. So there's no way you're getting across this in any shape or form in a car these days. But back in the day, this was the way to go. All the way up to the other side. Through those woods there. So this is the first of the river fords. This one is the furthest north on Valley Parkway, just before Lakewood, just before you come out onto Detroit Road. And here we are at our second river ford. This one's in Fairview Park, Ohio, also along the Valley Parkway. This one's kind of cool because it's got some 1930s WPA style brickwork. Okay, it leads right down to the river. And as you can see, nothing's been driving over this for a long time. Leaves, and the road kind of ends here. You can see the old curb here. All these leaves are piled up for the fall. Along the side here, you can see all the awesome brickwork. You can tell they used to put a lot of time and effort into their roads back in the day. And what you've got here is a rare treat, because usually this is completely underwater. Usually you can't even see the ford. So that tells you how low the river is right now. But this used to be Valley Parkway, and there's the modern day bridge over there. There's the old curbstones. in a week or so if it rains, and this is going to be completely and totally underwater. So this is kind of a cool situation. We got to videotape this in this environment. And there's Valley Parkway. New Valley Parkway, old Valley Parkway. And it's amazing that I haven't fallen in yet. That I have the balance of someone that's completely unbalanced. And that's where we were standing not more than a few minutes ago. And we'll take you on to the final ford in North Olmsted, which is in far better shape. So what used to be a roadway is now completely covered in water. And here we are at our third and final river ford. This one's in North Olmsted, right along the Valley Parkway, right by the Rocky River Nature Center right here in North Olmsted. And we're going to take a little walk down to the river. This one is in probably in the best shape of all of them. And especially right now with it being so dry, we can walk right across the entire thing. You might actually be able to take a car across this if you were able to get a car to it, which you can't. But in any case, let's take a look. Where we're at right now used to be the roadway, and it will come out on the actual ford. Right about here. And as you can see, as we come right onto the ford, there's huge chunks of concrete taken out. You can see the rebar right there. Okay, this was all built in the 1930s, when the Metroparks was first being built, and they built the first roadways through here. It was easier to construct a ford than it was to build a bridge. And there's Valley Parkway. And you can see the river is very, very, very low right now. Again, in different times of the year, this is underwater, but today we're in luck. Better times is where the water used to come through, used to come down from this side of the river, which is now completely dried up, down and into this covered drain here. And just a little bit of river trickling through today. That's it. That's all we've got. And at some crazier time in the season, there's probably a flood that washed this tree right up across the actual ford. You can kind of see, if you look real carefully, okay, the roadway does go right up to the Nature Center, connecting with Valley Parkway. Down here was the spillway. See, fords work kind of differently. Sometimes there would be water coming over this, and cars would drive right over the top of it, and this was the water where the water would spill off the sides. It wasn't quite like a bridge, but that's how they operated back in the day. If I can, I'm going to dig up some old pictures of what they used to look like when they were in operation and add them into this presentation. We'll see if I can find that or not. We'll see. And there hasn't been any road construction going on here in a long time. Looks like many of Cleveland's roads now. And if you look at the water level here, gang, we're talking about inches in the river. That's it. Inches of water. That's all that's here. It's barely flowing. That's how hot this season has been. It's very strange to have it be this hot and this dry in early October. The river has... I think I've only seen the river this low, and it was in 1988 when we had the drought. The great drought. And, you know, we're kind of back to that now. Our problem is there's not been any rain. So there you have it. These are the three river fords that used to be the Valley Parkway. Just a little piece of Cleveland history that's kind of neat, something you maybe not have known that was even there. And we're happy to have brought it to you here on Mr. P Explores. So until next time, head out there, enjoy the day, and keep on exploring.